The Nintendo Switch is basically just an NVIDIA shield with a screen stuck to it, detachable controllers, and of course, output to HDMI. It's because of this that it was pretty obvious that at some point people would get Android running on it, and they have. It's a ridiculously easy to do process. First of all, you download the image appropriately sized for your SD card of LineageOS. Then, you download the G apps, you write that image to the SD card, you move the Google Apps zip to the SD card as well, you put the SD card in your Switch and boot it into RCM or recovery mode, and then you boot into Hecate. I don't actually know how to pronounce this. From there, you boot into Android, hold volume up, and boot into recovery mode, this one being the Team Win recovery thing. From there, you can flash to Google Apps, and then reboot your Switch, boot back into recovery mode, boot back into Hecate, and reload Android, and boom, you're up and going. From here, I decided to run some benchmarks, but before I can do that, I actually have to, you know, go through the setup process. And you know it's cool when the first thing you see when you boot up your Switch running Android is process system isn't responding. Luckily, this was a non-issue, and it was just a random message that popped up. Anyway, setup was normal from there, just a regular Android tablet, basically. Then came the Google account screen, and I'm not gonna sign in, because sometimes when signing in and installing Google Apps, performance is hurt. After everything was done, the Switch booted up into what looks like a regular Android launcher. This is pretty much full LineageOS running on a Nintendo Switch. It kind of looks a little weird, though. It's just that I never imagined Android running on this machine, despite the fact it is basically an Android tablet. I had to manually enable developer options, which is really weird. I've never actually used LineageOS, but I'd expected the developer options to be enabled by default, since, well, you had to unlock your bootloader and pretty much do a bunch of other developer stuff to actually install LineageOS. Anyway, first thing I did was go and grab the latest version of Dolphin Emulator, which is a GameCube and Wii emulator to test out performance. However, when booting up a game, things didn't really go so well. I got this error over here. Apparently, the Switch doesn't really work very well with OpenGL when running Android. Apparently, the way to fix it is to switch to Vulkan, but I haven't really found a way to do that, so sadly, there's gonna be no GameCube benchmarks today. N64, however, had absolutely no troubles running on the Switch. I was playing Mario 64, and everything ran at a perfectly smooth 60fps, with pretty much no stuttering. Not that I would expect anything less from such a powerful Android tablet. I mean, N64 games can run on pretty much every phone at this point. The last emulation thing I wanted to try out was Nintendo DS. This is because Android is quite famously a platform where there's loads of Nintendo DS emulators to choose from. I tried out Drastic today, and while performance was pretty much top-notch, there were a couple of visual artifacts. However, I think this is purely up to the emulator. I decided to then run a Geekbench CPU test, and as you can see, it got a score of 240 for single-core performance and 825 for multi-core performance. Just for the hell of it, I ran the Geekbench compute test with Vulkan, and it gave me a score of 1338. I would try out some mobile games, but pretty much every single one that I tried stuttered horribly and barely worked. There's loads of entropy here, maybe I'm getting different performance than other people for various reasons. The Switch's fans also started whirring up for no reason during random moments. Not even during the Geekbench tests, just randomly started activating the fans, like while downloading something. Anyway, in the end, Android on Nintendo Switch is still very experimental. I wouldn't recommend using it as a tablet for gaming, but I heard stuff like PUBG Mobile works kinda well on it. The Tegra CPU is still pretty powerful, and maybe with some better optimization and a fix for that OpenGL error, this could be a very powerful gaming tablet that you can get for very cheap. I mean, really, it is basically a tablet, but it costs only $300. I mean, an NVIDIA Shield costs $150 for just the shield and a remote control. For $150 more, you can get a Switch. It comes with a screen, controllers, a dock to play it on the TV, and of course, access to Nintendo's library, along with pretty much all the functionalities of the NVIDIA Shield TV, except maybe some of the proprietary software for it. I'd say it's a pretty good deal, and it really makes sense that loads of these consoles are sold at a loss. Anyway, thank you for watching. If you want more videos about hacking the Nintendo Switch, then be sure to ask for them in the comments, and of course, obligatory advertising for the Discord server. It's a great fun time on there. Thanks for watching, and goodbye!